Hi, this is Carly Opson at the University of Arizona, and this is another short video in the series on visual analysis and graphing of data in single subject research designs. And I'm going to show you how to quickly put together a reversal design, an ABAB design graph, based on the AB graph that we created in our first video. And that's really the beauty of setting up a good graph format, is that in Excel, at least, you can copy it from one graph to another and reuse your data. You don't have to start from ground zero. I'll show you how to do that. So in our chart, in our Excel worksheets, we're going to jump to the AB1 worksheet. We are going to highlight Amy's behavior graph. We're not going to highlight just the plot data. We're going to highlight the chart area. We're going to copy it. We're going to go to ABAB1 and we are going to paste. So here's the graph. But the nifty thing that you can do is now you can click on the plot area. You can say that you want to select different data. So you want to select data. We're going to put the data for Cindy's graph into this graph. So I'm going to select the data. It bounces us back to the other page, but what we tell it is we have a different plan. So we click here to change the range. We move to the ABAB1 worksheet and we highlight the data range that we want. We're going to highlight all the way on our target and replacement data and over to our treatment integrity data. And say OK, that's what we want. And bingo, look, it's all changed. And let's go ahead and change this title because this is the Cindy graph. Cindy's behavior. There are a few things to clean up, but look at all that we've jumped around. We've already selected our data series and our chart type. We've formatted the chart so that it has no line around the border. We already have no legend. The vertical axis grid lines are gone. We have the scale set up properly and the horizontal axis off of the zero so that we don't lose some data points. And we have those both axis lines darkened so that you can see them more easily. We have the marker shapes set. We have the lines set. Really the only place where we're picking up here is that we have to set the trend line breaks, right? Because now they're not in the right place. Right? So we need to reconnect these breaks and then disconnect between the sixth and seventh data points. But let's connect these again first. Let's click once, click twice, and then format the data point. And we say we do want a line. And we want that line to be consistent and be 1.5 points. We want to format this data point. We do want a line. And we need to change the weight really quickly. Now let's put the breaks where they ought to be. Oh, and here's a line that showed up between treatment integrity data. Let's get rid of that. Click once, click twice on that data point. Format that data point and say no line. Now let's go back and put the lot breaks in where they should be. So between the sixth and seventh data points. Click once, click twice. Say no line. Same thing here. Click once, Click twice, so you're just highlighting the single data point, format that data point, say no line, and you would do the same thing between the 12th and 13th data points. And same thing here. And then finally, between the 15th and 16th data points. So really all there is now to do is, because we already have our chart title and our vertical and horizontal axis titles, is to copy this graph and move it to some other place like Microsoft Word. Some folks like to do this in PowerPoint, and finish the graph, do things like put in our phase lines, put in title, phase titles, take care of hiding this lower vertical axis area. Now, why don't you try copying over and changing the data source, or selecting data, and moving the graph from Amy's behavior to ABAB1, and turn it into a graph of Cindy's behavior.